There's a girl in real life, Peter Griffin here, and you're watching the worst carpet guy in the world, Carpet Mike, on Carpet Expert Blueprint. Frickin' sweet!
Thank you so much for that intro there, Peter Griffith. I truly do appreciate it. What's good, everybody? It's Michael Alder here from CarpetExpertBlueprint.com, and in this video, we're going to do a prep job on laying tech strip and padding, but more important than that, I want to share with you how you could be boosting your income on these little tiny jobs by doing what's already in your backyard. Now, here's what I mean by this. Every single install you do, there is leftover padding from the job site. You need to stockpile this stuff. And when you get these little tiny rental property jobs like this particular one, which is two bedrooms, one is a 12 by 15, the other bedroom is a 12 by 12, and you sell your leftover pad scraps in this job site, you're going to pick up about an extra $50 per room by doing this. Now, on these smaller jobs, they're almost not worth the time, but you should pick up any hustle that you absolutely can to increase your income. But having the pad basically being free to you and you could sell it to the client definitely makes things worth it, because you go from making a couple hundred bucks on a scenario like this to turning it into $300 on a tiny little job like this. And that $200 to $300 span there absolutely does add up. You could take that extra hundred, reinvest it, pay off some debt. You could party with it, whatever you're into, really. But the point is, leverage opportunities, take your scraps, turn them into cash, and really boost your income streams. Because, as we know, if you've been in the game a long enough time, easy money is not going to be around forever. Right now, we're in a cycle of very easy money, so leverage as much of it as you can, stockpile it, invest it, and that way you're set up for when stuff hits the fan again and it gets rough out there, you're good to go. Now, if you are a newbie in the carpet and flooring game, take notes on this. This will definitely help you in the cycles as things shift to help you leverage different strategies to keep your income growing high. So let's get back to the basics here. There's some more pad. We're going to slap that down. Da, da, da. Go ahead and get it all laid out. Staple it down. Trim it in. Everything's looking good. And we're going to go ahead and cut around the door jams there. Now, those bifold doors you see me pop off, those are not going back on. They were rubbing on the floor as is. So we're going to leave those off, and the carpenter is going to go ahead and trim those up and reinstall those for us. But just wanted to break down the prep on this job site. See that nice different color pad there? Same thickness, different distributor, but we're patching it all together. The clients are cool with that. It's a rental property. Everybody's good with it, so we all profit. Here I am, totally claustrophobic, stuck under a bed, and Chase Nasty thought it'd be hilarious to capture some pictures before I got dragged out from under there. So how do you actually unroll carpet so you don't totally destroy the walls and get it installed efficiently? So we're going to go ahead and go from side to side here, unrolling it, and then we're going to go ahead and back roll it, get it nice and loose. We're going to fold the sides in, spin it around, and then you get to open it back up. This is going to help you prevent from scratching up all the walls that have just been painted. Everything's nice and good to go. You don't want to do anything that's going to drive the customer nuts and have them doing any makeup work on it. So next, you're going to go ahead and grab your stretcher. Boom, 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 boom. Stretch it in, crease it on, tuck it, and then it's going to pop back off like that because this is incredibly thick carpet. So we're basically just setting this wall, tucking it, getting it locked onto the strip, and then we're going to go ahead and take that stretch downtown, lock it on with the crab, kick it into place, lock it on nice and tight, get everything secured, trimmed and beautiful, and crab one more time. For the sidewall there, we're going to go ahead and trim and tuck that. I was mesmerized by the chalkboard wall there. Totally threw my game off on the speech here. Super cool scenario to have in your room there. Some people have whiteboards, other people have full-on chalkboards. I don't know which one's better, but as long as you're taking notes on the game of life and expanding, you're good to go. So as always, I truly appreciate you tuning in. Thank you so much, and we'll connect on the next video.